there are drug-resistant bacteria, unfortunately. So how is that kind of affecting, or how can that affect someone's ability to fight off the infection and what that might lead to?
So as Dr. Diegas mentioned, there are certain bacteria that can live on our skin every day without causing any signs of infection. Those bacteria are called Staphylococci and Streptococci. Staphylococcus is a bacterial organism that has been present for ages and centuries. It lives on our skin. However, with this age of new antibiotics, what started happening whenever people develop infections with Staphylococcus, from simple cuts. Antibiotics are introduced and they do kill off most of this bacteria and infection. However, a couple of them survive and they mutate and they become resistant to most common antibiotics, the penicillin type of antibiotics. And here we are with this new scary infection called MRSA.
Oh, yes.
What MRSA is essentially a staphylococcus that has mutated and became so strong that no regular antibiotic will kill it. MRSA is obviously more prevalent in hospitals, in nursing homes. However, it's no longer just a hospital-acquired infection, no longer just nursing home-acquired infection. It can occur anywhere. To be honest, me and Dr. Diegas probably have MRSA living on our skin rather than regular Staphylococcus just from being exposed to it in the hospital all the time. Scary to say. But MRSA or regular Staphylococcus still require a cut or some way, they need some way to be introduced into the skin, into a deeper layer of the skin to cause infection.